Well, the Cuba studio last spring, which was a level two studio, the overview follows my philosophy about architecture. And that is that I don't believe students should just be at MIT inside these walls designing for people around the world. I think the issue is maintaining identities of people, of cultures, being sensitive to climate conditions, architecture, where we are, where they, in this case, may be working. So the theory behind it is to take my students to a place that they don't know, immerse them into that culture as quickly as possible, let them talk to the people, let them move around the city, let them absorb what there is about that place, so that when they design, it was a design project, they're coming from the point of sensitivity to the people and to the culture, not from some Western notion about what architecture should be, or not some from some intellectual position, although that's important, but they're coming from understanding the site, understanding the buildings, the people, the culture, the history. So that's central to all my work, and as an overview, and the Cuban studio is an example of that. I think the goals of the studio and also working with Cuba are somewhat similar. I go places where I am invited and where the studio can help, because MIT has incredible resources, and let's share them with the rest of the world if we can. So actually, the project in Cuba was one that they wanted, because they want prototypes about how to develop areas. In terms of what I want students to get out of this, I want them to make the most beautiful buildings in the world, but I want those buildings to relate to the people. And so I'm not just teaching how to design buildings, which of course is part of the studio, nor am I teaching just that we should make beautiful buildings, but we should be making the best architecture we can make and respond to the people's needs. Now, I'm critical of our profession, because I think often architects are what I call technocrats. They just kind of follow what somebody tells them to do, and they're technicians. So my goal for the students is to come away, of course, with opening doors into a new way of looking at architecture. There may never be a typical week, but I'll tell you the ingredients that go into teaching is a combination. Today I'm going to show some of my own work, so it's a combination of lecturing about work that I've done, and more importantly, how I've gotten to that work, not only the work. It's a combination about lectures of particular subjects, maybe materials or sunlight, issues that I'm concerned about. It's an intense experience, what we call desk side crits, where you sit down with a student and you look at their work, and it's kind of an interesting process. I've done it for years. You quickly see what they're doing. They've sketched something or they've made a model. And you have to very quickly say what you think about that. And we have what we call pin-ups, which are reviews. In my case, they're quite often once a week, where the students put their work up and we, as a class, talk about it. I encourage my studio class to actually engage in the discussion about the work. And in fact, just last week, I asked them to trade models, exchange models, and talk about each other's work, because to get them out of your own way of thinking. And then there's periods of just working in the studio, and then full-scale reviews where I invite people in from other faculty at the school or other professions to give them feedback. I think in the studio teaching, it's important to get out of the studio and to go into the what I call the library of architecture form, everything that's around us. In all my studios, the site is very important to understand. I tell them that when I was in school, I used to go sleep on the site for a weekend and cook out and so on, so that I could get to know the site as well as my own backyard. And then I would come back and announce to my professor that the site was too beautiful to build on. And I'm glad I'm not one of my students. But anyways, the point is to absorb the sight as much as you can, absorb the outside. So I think part of the studio, or a big part of the studio, is getting out of here, getting out of MIT. Now, the other side of that is that I bring people in who know about, in this case, Havana, Cuba, to talk, to give their views. I want my students to know as many different views as they can, and then from that they make a decision. So I think the teaching of a studio and the teaching of architects is the most important thing we can do, because I think the architects are the only ones that are going to be looking out for the physical world. And the physical world is in bad shape, and in this generation it may disappear as we know it. I think of architects as caretakers of the physical world. I think we have to be sensitive, much more sensitive than we have been, to cultures, to the land, to the forest, to the water, to everything, materials. We are more than technicians. We are what I call creative leaders. And I think that's a new role for us, and I think it's a very important one that we take very seriously.